An 87-page report on the state insurer PhilHealth will be presented by Senate President Vicente Soto III before the plenary on Tuesday. Soto's report as chairman of the Senate Committee of the Whole will carry the findings borne out of the three-day-long probe into the supposed anomalies hounding the agency. These include the 14.9 billion peso interim reimbursement mechanism funds, which portions were also given to dialysis and maternity cases. The reported overpriced 2.1 billion peso network switch or IT project. Allegations of false claims, case rates, padded number of patients, exaggerated medical cases, and favored hospitals. All these alleged irregularities, according to the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, have already resulted to some 200 billion pesos spilled PhilHealth funds. Soto assures the public of an airtight report comparing it to salakab, a native farming tool that is being used to trap pests.
Ang salakab kasi ito yung sa bukid na ginagamit, yung parang gawa ito ng handicraft ito eh. Na kung saan, pagka inilubog mo yung sa lupa, sa tubig, sa putik, maski ano, pwede mahuli. Sabi nga ni Senator Bato, pati butete kayang hulihin.
Lacson also pictures a heavy committee report that was based from strong evidence and solid testimonies. He's also optimistic erring PhilHealth officials will have a day in court.
Maganda yung prospects dahil ngayon lang naman yung after so many investigations. Ngayon lang nag-design yung top officials. Hindi nga pinag-design. I could sense the way, in the way si Secretary Guevara pursued us in providing them copies of the proceedings ng Senate, nakita ko talaga decidido. Plus the fact that the President has already thrown his full support to Secretary Guevara.
The Soto report only needs 13 affirmative votes for it to be adopted by the chamber. The Senate has also endorsed PhilHealth Board Member Alejandro Cabading, Regional Vice President Dennis Adre, and resigned Anti-Fraud Officer Thorson Keith to the Witness Protection Program. But they have yet to receive a word if they have been accepted to the WPP. The Philippine Justice Department vows to consider the findings of the Senate. Three more resource persons will face Task Force PhilHealth on Wednesday. The task force has already recorded the testimonies of 10 resource persons. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.